So we've been following the mayoral race that's taking place in Buffalo, New York for quite some time on this program, and there really shouldn't be anything to talk about at this point. There shouldn't, but there is. So in this city, in Buffalo, it's heavily slanted towards the Democratic Party. So if you win the Democratic Party primary, you are essentially going to win the general election. It's usually a foregone conclusion, but that's not necessarily the case here, because India Walton defeated the incumbent Democratic Party mayor, Byron Brown, and he has refused to concede. Okay, now you'd think, what's the big deal? He's not conceding. So what? She's still going to win, except he's chosen to not concede and run a sore loser write-in campaign. And when you are the four-term incumbent mayor with a lot of name recognition and, more importantly, big money donors on your side, I think that that write-in campaign is something that actually could be competitive, which is frustrating. But nonetheless, here we are. And I want to share a quick clip from an interview that India Walton did with Jen Perlman and Peter Hager. And she explains the situation. And it's just, it's truly, truly frustrating.
So I won the Democratic primary. 65% of registered voters in Buffalo are Democrats, right? So you win the Democratic primary. Traditionally, it's assumed you're the presumptive mayor. Well, the 16-year, four-term incumbent didn't concede. He started a write-in campaign. And not only is he doing a write-in campaign, but a couple of weeks ago, he got a local judge to rule that our state Board of Elections deadline to file independent nominating petitions was unconstitutional and put him back on the ballot. So we had to appeal that decision. We went to court. We got him off the ballot. But now, like, all of this Republican money is being flooded into the race. There's independent expenditures. There are commercials that are, like, blatantly lying, saying I'm going to lay off 100 police officers who are all going to be people of color and women. A video surfaced last night of him saying that I'm going to allow rapists free and sex predators. It's just ridiculous. But, you know, he has so much power and privilege and money that they're able to play these things on a constant loop. And, you know, the more people hear this stuff, the more likely they are to actually believe that it's true. So it's funny in a way. And then in a way, it's kind of not, because we won fair and square and really want to bring positive change for working class people in Buffalo. And we're up against this monumental, pretty nasty fight.
Yeah, so if this write-in campaign works, it really speaks to how powerful big money is in the United States. Now, I hope that it doesn't work. I hope that he fails, obviously, because India Walton is the real deal. She actually wants to tackle poverty. She actually ran a competitive primary, and Byron Brown did nothing. He sat on his ass, and he expected himself to just win by default. He didn't run a campaign. So she won. Her constituents clearly chose her over him, and yet he's refusing to step down. So she needs help. It's not like she's automatically going to win because she defeated him in the Democratic Party primary. This is basically part two of the Democratic Party primary, except now whoever wins actually does get sworn in as the mayor. So she needs a lot of help. And there's been leftists who are speaking out, but now the most important leftist in the country has chosen to stake his claim here. Bernie Sanders, and he is going to war for India Walton. So he actually sent out a fundraising email on her behalf, encouraging all of his supporters to donate to her campaign. And it reads, when Democratic Socialist India Walton launched her campaign for mayor of Buffalo, they said she was too radical to win. She said she was bold and visionary. They said she had no chance to beat a four-term incumbent. Then, earlier this year, she shocked everyone and won a close primary race that was only possible because she showed the political power of an agenda that puts people first. Much like we did when I first was elected mayor of Burlington 40 years ago. Now the establishment incumbent she defeated in the primary is running a write-in campaign in the general election, which is less than a month away. He is being funded by wealthy corporate developers and fighting for an agenda that benefits them. Quote, when we think about socialism, you know, we're perfectly fine with socialism for the rich. We bail out Wall Street banks and give $1 billion in tax incentives to one of the richest people in the world. And when it comes to providing resources working families need to thrive, socialism becomes scary. that may remind you a lot of our campaign, but it was India Walton's response to attacks calling her a democratic socialist. She ran a bold campaign, she talked about the issues people care about, and she won. Now, India Walton's opponent may have the support of people like Carl Palladino, a Trump-supporting Republican real estate developer, but India Walton has something her opponent does not, and that is the people. Now, there's another part from Bernie's fundraising email that I'm going to read to you, but I just want to pause right there and talk about how important this is, because Bernie Sanders is a fundraising machine. He doesn't have this huge contact list of elites, millionaires, billionaires, donors that he can call, but he does have this huge email list that the DNC was thirsting for, which he never gave to them, I'm assuming, and that in and of itself can do wonders. By sending out this one email, he probably helped her raise tens of thousands of dollars, and that really makes a difference in a city where every penny is going to count. So if you also want to support India Walton, I will link you to her campaign website down below. You can donate $1, $2, $3, $27, whatever you donate helps. Because if she can actually win and be a successful blueprint for what can be done to improve people's lives, then obviously that benefits the cause of leftists overall. Now, there's another thing that I want to point out that Bernie Sanders talked about in this email, and it was too perfect to not share. He writes, "When progressives lose elections, we are all supposed to get in line and rally around the establishment candidate and do everything we can to help them win, and we do. When progressives win, they get primaries like AOC, Rashida, and Ilhan all did last cycle. But much like those three, India is going to rally the support of working people, and she's going to win as well." And so I love that he made this point, because I've made the same point as well. It's so frustrating. It's infuriating. Democrats will always say after the primary is over, okay, it's time to vote blue no matter who. It's time to get in line behind the person who won. But you can see now firsthand that when it happens to somebody that they don't like, they're not willing to preach unity. In fact, Byron Brown is doing everything he possibly can to divide people. And it's truly, it's interesting that nobody in the establishment has called him out. Is Nancy Pelosi or Jim Clyburn going to come out and denounce Byron Brown? No, of course not. Because it's unity for thee and not me. That's the mantra of the Democratic Party. And even like putting aside this race, back in 2020, when it looked likely that Bernie Sanders was going to become the nominee because he had the most pledged delegates, well, we remember the talks of Joe Biden, Elizabeth Warren. They all raised their hands when asked if somebody who didn't get the most votes should win, possibly. Essentially implying, is it okay or is it permissible or morally right to use superdelegates to steal the nomination away from someone that we don't like? And we saw what happened. Everyone raised their hands. Bernie Sanders was the only person who said, no, the person with the most votes is the person who should become the Democratic Party nominee. And we never saw what happened, but I think that we all could have anticipated a lot of corporate Democrats denouncing Bernie Sanders, possibly endorsing Donald Trump over him. I mean, this is all speculative, right? Because we can't run back and play that out to see what happens in an alternate setting. But still, it's frustrating that Democrats continue to do this again and again and again. And this race with Byron Brown is a microcosm of a bigger issue of the Democratic Party doing everything they can to stop progressives, but prop themselves up. And, you know, it's because they're serving their donors. They're operating at the behest of the people who get them into power in the first place. But either way, it's good to see Bernie Sanders shame them for their hypocrisy, and it's good to see him fundraise for India Walton, because even though I think that she has a really great chance of winning, I don't want to risk it. I don't want this to be another race where we lose. I mean, we just saw, a victory taken from us with Nina Turner. We were right there, and we lost. So I don't want that to be the case again. I don't want to take any chances. Definitely, if you can, support India Walton, because if she is successful, this is a win for all of us, not just India Walton, not just Buffalo. It's a win for all of us.